I'm Peggy LeBeau. Welcome back to the Fourth Revolution, where I discuss stocks for your portfolio of the future. I'm discussing the two-day meeting, which ended yesterday for the FOMC, and Jerome Powell's hawkish comments in his press conference post-meeting. So there's a statement released yesterday about 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, and this had some driving impacts on the market. So more FOMC officials on the dot plot chart, which guides the markets onto what to expect for interest rates in the future, are now betting on 2023 having two hikes. So the Fed is now getting a little bit more hawkish on their verbiage, and you can see it in their dot plot chart, as well as some of the things that Jerome Powell has been saying. So immediately after this dot plot chart was released at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, like I said, we had a huge boom in the yields for the 10-year, and the markets fell off a cliff. We had all the major indexes down over 1%, and this is following a pretty even keel day to begin with. So immediate off the block, right down over 1%, and then Jerome Powell comes on stage at 2:30 and starts speaking some sweet words of tapering. And this is what the markets want. The markets want to see some tapering from this $120 billion monthly asset purchase program that they have going right now. So they're purchasing $80 billion in treasury bonds, and they're purchasing another $40 billion in mortgage-backed securities every month. And markets are thinking that this is just too much right now for what the economy is doing, for how fast we are recovering from this pandemic. And, you know, we saw the reaction after Jerome Powell alluded to the idea that we might see some tapering pretty soon here. He said this is the talking about tapering meeting, which is a change in language from the not thinking about thinking about raising rates. So this was kind of a relief for a lot of investors. And it was interesting. We actually saw a bid in tech. And I think this is because investors had already priced out so much because of this expected interest rate hike. So we priced in this interest rate hike into tech already. And now that it's coming to fruition, and actually we actually have some kind of idea of when this interest rate increase is going to happen, as in tapering will be the first move, the first lever, so to speak, that the Fed pulls to raise interest rates. And now that we have, you know, some kind of idea that this is going to happen soon, I think the markets are starting to have some ease in jumping back in to a lot of these high growth names that have just been destroyed. I mean, for example, Splunk has taken down 50%. It's a unprofitable company, and it's just been absolutely destroyed because of this discount deflation that we've had from rising interest rates. And yesterday we got an over 1.5% bid on it when the rest of the market was plummeting. Splunk was able to stay buoyant. And it's interesting because this is the complete opposite of what you would intuitively think would happen on an interest rate spike. So let's take a look at the charts and see what happened in real time here, and dive into what the FOMC is actually planning to do. This is the U.S. 10-year Treasury yield on TradingView.com, and you can see you've had an absolute burst in this benchmark interest rate from our lows back here in the beginning of August at 0.5%, driving all the way up to roughly 1.78 to 1.77 back in the end of March. And this is because the markets were kind of betting against the Fed. The Fed has been using this word transitory as it relates to inflation for quite a long time. And the markets are saying, no, this inflation isn't transitory. There's too much sticky pricing pressure, so to speak, in the markets that's going to allow this increase in prices to sustain. And, you know, I don't necessarily believe that. I think there are a lot of inflationary pressures that are related to the reopening, and Jerome Powell said as much in his commentary yesterday during his press release. And, you know, we're starting to trust the Fed. We have been at least since the end of March. And you can see that with this 10-year tapering down and tapering down into this meeting. I don't think investors and traders were expecting to see anything hawkish out of yesterday's guidance. And it was a big surprise when we saw that the Fed was pricing in two rate hikes in 2023. But as I was saying, Jerome Powell kind of, you know, reduced the concern for the broader market, saying you should take this dot plot chart with a grain of salt and that we're only going to make moves based off of what's happening with the data. He did increase, or should I say, the overall FOMC did increase their guidance for inflation, which was also a little bit of a concern. They used the PCE inflation instead of CPI, but the PCE inflation number is now expected to be 3.4 for the year, opposed to their March projection, which was 2.4. And, you know, that kind of drove a little bit of the yield up. But looking at the 15-minute chart, you can see that the minute that this guidance hit the markets, we just saw an absolute sell-off in bonds. You know, bonds and their yields are inversely correlated. So the yield drove up, bonds were sold off. And, you know, we did that up until Jerome Powell started speaking right around here. And he was speaking about tapering. And tapering is the word that the markets keep wanting to hear. We want to hear that they're making moves to fight this inflation, because inflation is getting, you know, is getting out of hand in a lot of different sectors. We saw it with lumber driving up, you know, like 600% from the lows to the highest level it's ever been. And it's funny because Jerome Powell actually cited that as one of the transitory factors, saying that its recent drop-off was an example of how short-term this inflation is. But, you know, lumber is still trading at – lumber futures, that is, on a CME exchange are still trading at 80% above their pre-pandemic highs. Nonetheless, we saw some, like I said, some tapering comments from Jerome that alluded to the fact that we could start tapering this, you know, $120 billion monthly asset purchase down a little bit in the near future. And he said that he's going to give the markets an advance notice before he does anything. And Jerome Powell has a track record of telegraphing all of his information to the markets, so there is no shock. I mean, we had a taper tantrum back when Bernanke was the head of the Fed because he shocked the markets. But, you know, we're expecting tapering now, and it seems like that's beginning to be priced in. And we're seeing that in tech. This is the NASDAQ 100 chart on TradingView. And you can see from the 15-minute chart, all the indexes dropped off over 1% following the guidance that we had of increased inflation and increased interest rates sooner than anticipated, like I said. But the tapering comments that Jerome Powell had, the talking about tapering, this change in language actually allowed traders to get back onto the bid of a lot of these tech companies, because it kind of illustrated that, you know, this fear of inflation, this fear of interest rates rising, is no longer going to be an issue. Once he actually starts making moves towards an interest rate hike, the fear of an interest rate hike is no longer there. A lot of this interest rate fears have been priced into tech, and you saw that from the beginning of this year. Tech had been a huge underperformer of the broader market because of this discount that we had been seeing in valuations. Obviously, as interest rates go up, this kind of cash flows for companies is discounted at a higher rate. And for growth companies, their future cash flows are much larger than their current cash flows, which makes them a little bit more sensitive to interest rates. But as I said, we are starting to see a bid, and we kind of bought the rumor of inflation and interest rate increases when we're looking at the, so the orange line here is going to be the Dow Jones 30, and this is, you know, the pillar of value cyclical plays. And that outperformed the entire market, but it seems like tech is coming back to leadership here as the markets have some ease about what's happening with the interest rates. Investors and traders have been positioning themselves for this inflationary and higher interest rate environment that they've been expecting. And now that the Fed and Jerome Powell are talking about tapering, they're starting to reverse their positioning. They're selling off value and cyclical stocks that have had a run since the beginning of the year, and they are buying up tech, which has underperformed. And I think tech could be an outperformer in the second half of 2021. So don't forget to check out Zacks.com/promo, where we have stocks under $10 a share. Thanks for watching, guys. Look forward to seeing you guys next time.